Hi guys, so today I'm going to be installing a weave and I will be using hair from Fabulous Hair Europe. It is virgin Indian hair, 14 inch, and it's just the process of how I do it, and I've never really done a video where I show you guys how I install a weave, so this will be the opportunity for you guys to see it. Hope you enjoy the video, thank you.
Grandma, you go ahead, girl. Woo! We're gonna do some singing, we're gonna do some dancing, musicians gonna do some playing. Just don't get out of control, guys, alright? Here we go!
So Marie, describe the braid pattern and why you chose to do it that way.
For your hair today, I just decided, because you said you wanted a middle parting and you wanted to go for off-center parting sometimes, I felt the best way to make it as flat as possible is to kind of pack it all back. And what I did is I plaited and then I folded the plait into the next plait so that it stays the same all the way through, and you'll be able to pull up your hair and do whatever you want with it. It's one of the easiest way I know how to plait whilst staying tight and flat. And what we're now going to do is I'm going to sew it around with the hair and it should stay flat all the way down, so it's quite an easy way to plait. So if any of you guys are doing a plait, it's a very nice way. Plus at the back here you have so many plaits that you can't really see the scalp, so the hair can actually be sewn onto hair all the way through and you won't have any gaps, and you have something to plait onto so there's no gaps. Yeah, so I'm gonna get started. How's it feeling?
It feels great. Not tight. I can move my head. I haven't gotten a mini facelift.
Yeah.
That's it, from the braids. It feels really comfortable. It's not tight. My edges aren't pulling at all. I'm really liking it so far. So stay tuned for the next update.
Into the hair, just going to show how I fold over on the sides. I want it to lay flat, so I tend to just pull on it into it and then just fold it over. And then as flat as you can, and then go back over it to make sure that the corners lay flat and there's no bump. That way the sides are invisible. There you go. Say not
back with the finished product, as you can see. Marie has done a brilliant job. I am so, so happy. The hair just feels amazing. The braids underneath, they're not too tight. You know, I haven't got that kind of like full facelift effect. So I'm not in pain. I don't need any painkillers. And the hair, I mean, we trimmed it after we finished applying it, and it feels really good. As you can see, it looks really, really good. So I'm a really happy bunny. So I'll let Marie talk a bit more about what she did today.
The weave installation today was very easy. She's got really nice soft hair, so I literally came over the hair all back in the direction of what she wanted to achieve. So she'll be able to achieve an off-center parting and a middle parting, because we've left quite a lot of leave out. And my main concern with weaves are three things. It has to be tight. It has to be not too tight to cause breakage. It has to be flat at the top. And this was inspired by one of my best friends. She hates when she has to kind of fight with her leave out to cover the tracks, and then if the wind blows, you know, you're kind of found out. So I made sure that I sewed the last row kind of as near to her scalp as possible, so that when it grows out, she won't have that kind of, you can see the plait, you can see the hair will kind of flow. And also, I left out some hair at the front, as you can see, so she can actually pull it back when she wants. And I created a little amount of layers just so that she can have a bit more movement. But the hair is so nice that there wasn't really that much that I needed to do with it. And I just ran through it straight with the GHDs. And we didn't put any product in it. And I think it had a bit of serum in it.
I had a little bit of Paul Mitchell Wild Ginger Aloe Vera styling oil, which is really lovely. Serum smells amazing. It's really light. And it's great heat protected as well.
Yeah, so I would say when you're doing your weaves, take care of the hair that's underneath. Don't kind of think, I've got a weave so I don't have to do anything. You still need to take care of it. There still needs to be treatment. What's underneath still needs to be moistured, conditioned, and all of that. Fair enough, it looks good, but there's no point in doing a weave looking good and then you have breakage at the end of it. So look after your hair with and without the weave. That's what I would say.
Thanks, Marie. So, you've been watching my long hair journey. Thank you, Marie.
No problem.
Check out the description box at the bottom and you can see a link to Marie's blog, which is amazing, by the way, full of lots of really cool information and amazing pictures. You can also check back at mylonghairjourney.co.uk for more information about the weave, how we installed it, some additional pictures, and also keep watching the blog because I'll be updating regularly on how I look after this weave and style it for the next, hopefully 2 months, maybe more. So, you know, keep watching us. I'd like to thank Fabulous Hair Europe for the hair, which just is so amazing. It just feels amazing and it looks amazing. So thank you for watching, and we'll see you soon.